is my little helper. Yesterday, I did a podcast about infinite possibility, and it was inspired by this amazing brunch. So I wanted to share it to you in Reader's True Reality, forming a loop of craziness, of infinite possibility existing to us in every moment. Today's podcast is about reaching out with our ears. As we live today in a world of humming fridges, whirring air conditioning, roaring traffic, airplanes, we shut down our ears. We don't mean to do it, but we don't really want to hear those sounds. When I'm recording a podcast, if an airplane goes over, I wait until it's passed, and it takes about 3 minutes, and then I continue because I want to give you like the pure sounds of the stream. You can probably hear it in the background, rushing maybe, the birds, the wind. And yet, not long ago, we would have reached out with our ears to the furthest places that we could, to listen to the bird song as far away as we could, to understand what was going on, to hear what might be coming or what might be available for us to eat, in every direction. Our entire being would be extended through our ears. Pretty different. That's what today's podcast is about. Welcome to Choose Your Grooves. This is the Visionary Podcast, where the birds tell us the answer. My name is Mary Jane. I'm sitting in a bush. It's about 6:30 in the morning. The main excitement of it being day has now moved on to the busyness of the birds. Thousands and thousands and thousands of years, we have evolved to listen intently to these sounds. To reach with our ears into the far distance, and to focus on perhaps one particular bird song. These are the sounds we have evolved with and for. We're designed to respond to. As I sit in this bush, my
ears really do seem to extend out in all directions, as far as possible. To absorb the detail and the sounds near and far. Isn't this quite different to when an aeroplane goes over, or a car, the traffic goes by, or with those sort of noises we shut our ears down. Being a bit crazy, perhaps, and living very, very remotely and quite alone a lot, I listen to the birds. And in fact, they tell me what to do. They have the best advice. I literally ask questions and then open my ears. Answers pour in, and the wonderful thing is that wherever you are, there are some birds nearby. Maybe you walk past them on the way to work. Or maybe they sing outside your window. Normally it's going to be the same bird every time, or same group of birds. They hang out in their particular territory. And they know you. They see you. And they're singing to you. And I want to encourage you to stretch out your ears. And tune in to what they say, because they really do say the most marvelous things. They always seem to say encouraging and uplifting, loving things. And and all over the world, no matter where you are. They manage to get there. They're even inside the supermarkets. And we can train ourselves to listen. To reach into the distance again. Here comes the wind excitingly. I bet there are messages for you. Today and every day in the birds that you hear singing. Just tune in, hear them, reach out with your ears, say hello. And listen, and you might find you have the most sweet and lovely message that you hear all day. I love you. An aeroplane. Time to go.